Thanks, Mark. Well, after a good upturn, or rally as it is known in the financial sector, US stocks have now retreated. Financial shares fell for the first time in 3 days on growing scepticism that the Federal Reserve's plan to buy bonds will revive the US economy. The Fed will effectively look to print money in order to buy their own debt, which has been issued. The result will help to force down interest rates for US borrowers. Home loan rates have already fallen to under 5% for a 30-year loan. Equity markets are usually the first to move when an economy is on the rebound, so many had hoped that the recent gains were the magical sign that the outlook was improving in the US. The New Zealand dollar seems unstoppable at present, rising through the 50s and now sitting in the mid 55 cents to the US dollar, and is up over 2% from yesterday. As global exporters producing primary produce for other markets, we really want to see the New Zealand dollar fall out of bed into the 40s and stay there for a while. This would help to offset some lower international commodity prices that we are seeing. If the dollar remains at these higher levels or even continues moving up, this will likely have an effect on local farmgate prices. The dollar has been moving higher after the US Fed announcement of injecting further cash into their economy, as I mentioned earlier in this piece. This has renewed investors' appetite for offshore currencies, with the dollar moving up by 1.5 cents yesterday and another 2 cents today. It was trading at around 49 cents just last Wednesday. Overseas dairy producers are calling for more government support. There have been protests by farmers and spilt milk on doorsteps of government agencies as farmers feel the pinch. Czech farmers are predicting that it costs them 7 Czech crowns to produce milk, while the price they are receiving is only 5.8 crowns. European officials are suggesting that many farmers are going out of business and support is needed. This will be an interesting development over coming months. Further subsidies are likely to drive down international prices and affect future payouts. However, if further subsidies are not introduced or withdrawn, as this has been lobbied by the World Trade Organization, then we may see a shortage of supply down the track as overseas farmers go out of business. This will be good news for our local dairy farmers. So while dairy payouts have dropped this year, New Zealand is faring well compared to our dairy competitors.